So we're going to talk now about the fundamentals and the basic principles of playing tug with your dog. There's some rules that we want to keep in mind every time we play tug with our dog. The first of which is we're using the dog's prey drive or desire to chase to build their initial interest in tugging. So the tug should move away from the dog when you're trying to get the dog to chase the tug. Don't shove the toy at the dog when you begin tugging. So if we want our dog to chase the tug, we make the tug move away from the dog in straight lines, ideally. So I can hold it in one hand, I can make it run from the dog like this. I can hold it in both hands, make it jump away from the dog like this, but the idea is the toy is moving away from the dog to encourage them to chase and grab. This does a couple of things. It brings the dog's prey drive up, makes them want to chase and grab. The second is it builds a good strike on the toy. It builds the dog's desire to drive into the toy. Prey never goes at the dog. That's a good thing to keep in mind. There's a term that people frequently use called no suicide rabbits. Like a rabbit would never run into your dog's mouth, and we're looking at the toy sort of like a rabbit. Don't shove it at your dog. And this is a really common mistake that people make when they're initially playing. They hold the toy still and they want the dog to take the toy, and they go like this and stick the toy at the dog. Does a couple of things. It inhibits the dog's strike because the toy's coming at them. It doesn't get the dog's prey drive activated, so the dog doesn't take the toy with as much energy. And the other thing is the toy going into the dog's mouth tends to make the dog want to chew on the toy. So, principle number one, toy moving away from the dog and moving away from the dog in straight lines. The second thing is that once the toy is grabbed by the dog, that the toy has to try to get away from the dog. We're playing tug, which means that then at the point that the dog grabs the toy, I want the toy to jump forward in the dog's mouth as if it were trying to get away from the dog. The other mistake, common mistake people make, is they make a presentation, the dog grabs the toy, and then as they play tug with the dog, they push the toy in and out of the dog's mouth like this. Like they're doing the laundry, right? Like they're shaking out a towel. By pushing into the dog's mouth, every time they push in, they take all the energy out of the toy, and the dog tends to want to chew around on the toy or let go of it. As opposed to if the dog's on the toy, and I pull forward on the dog's mouth in little bursts, like the toy is trying to jump forward out of the dog's mouth. This will make the dog want to clamp down on the toy and hold on to it more firmly, and they don't chew around and move their grip. The other thing that we want to cover here is making clear presentations for our dog. So one of the common mistakes that people make when they start moving the toy away from the dog is not giving the dog a clear shot at the toy. If you don't do this, two things happen. One is either you get bit, or the second is that the dog quits trying to get the toy because it doesn't think it has a fair shot at getting it. So some of the common mistakes people make with a tug, the tug's out here, they want to give the dog a toy, they go like this to move the toy away from the dog, and they leave their hand behind. By turning their body this way, they move the toy away from the dog all right, but they turned it so the dog didn't have a clear shot at the toy. And they either get bit in the hand, or the dog sits back and doesn't go for the toy because it doesn't feel it has a clear shot. So one of the things that I need to do is make a clear presentation. So when I move the toy away from the dog, that means I have to turn the toy to orient it towards the dog. So I'll show you here, kind of in slow motion, what it would look like. If the dog was sitting in front of me, I have the toy here in front of my body, I would move the toy away from the dog, but I would turn the toy so the dog has a clear shot at the toy as it moves away. And then an added thing that I do is I get my body out from behind the toy so that the dog can really hit it without slamming into me. So it would go like that on that side, or like that on that side. So you can see the toy moving away from the dog, but every time I move it away, I have to turn the toy so the dog has a clear shot. So we want clear presentations. It's also important for our the fundamental early stages of tugging that we make presentations in a variety of different ways. What tends to happen with people is they make the same tug presentation every time. So if my dog's here, this is a very common one, the dog lets go, this dog's sitting in front of me, I would say yes, and I would pop the tug straight up and into my body like this. It's a very common presentation. If I consistently do that, later on, if I go to present the tug in a different way or in a different place, then the dog goes here instead of to where the tug is. So one of the first things that we want in the fundamental play thing is to teach the dog to target the tug no matter where it is in relation to my body and give the dog a variety of presentations. So I'll give the dog a presentation on my left side, out to the side. I'll give the dog a presentation on my right side. I'll give my dog a high presentation. I'll give my dog a low presentation. I'll frequently turn this way and give a presentation out to the side of my body from behind and on this side as well. And that variety of presentations makes the dog target the toy correctly, and it allows me to give the dog the reward in a variety of different places in relation to my body. So later on, when I go to healing or any of the other obedience behaviors, I can produce the toy. If the dog were on my side healing, I could produce the toy above the dog's head on that side, and he can jump up and bite it. If the dog's in front of me and I want to give a presentation out here, the dog's clear on that and can target the toy in a variety of different places. Once the dog's biting the toy, I want to tug hard enough to keep the dog engaged, but not so hard that the dog feels either overwhelmed or stressed about it. One of the chief problems that we have crop into our tug play with our dogs is the problem of possession of the toy. It's a really common problem in our work. The dog doesn't want to play with me. They want to get the item and take it away from me and keep the item. And possession gets in the way of our whole tugging relationship. The dog's motivated for the toy, but not so motivated for the interaction with the handler. And again, remember, we really want to create engagement with the handler. So one of the chief ways that we create possession in dogs is by tugging too hard. So if I have a young dog and I'm beginning to tug, and I'm tugging really vigorously, I'm swinging the dog around, picking their feet off the ground, putting a lot of energy into the tugging. When they finally, and the dog will start, frequently it makes some intensity in the dog, they're pulling back very hard, they're putting a lot of energy into it, but when they finally get it, they don't want to bring it back to me because they had to work too hard to get it. So I want to moderate my tug play in a way that says, hey, this is fun, I'm tugging hard enough to keep you engaged in it, but not so hard that the dog wants to take the toy away and possess. The other thing that we do is that we need to pull hard enough to keep the dog engaged, but not so hard that they feel overwhelmed. So pulling very hard can create possession, but pulling very hard with a young dog can also make that dog feel like they're not in control of the game and they quit. So if I continually yank the toy out of the dog's mouth for pulling too hard, if I pull so hard that they're constantly slipping off the toy, I can actually kill drive in the dog. I can make that dog feel overwhelmed, like they're not in control, and they become passive. And if I have a very good dog, the dog just hangs on the toy. And if I have a not so good dog, they quit playing with me altogether because they can't control the situation. So one of the things that we do, and the younger the dog, the narrower that productive window of play is. So if I'm playing with a young puppy, the window of productive tugging intensity is very narrow. If I pull too hard, the little puppy can't hold on, says, I don't want to do this game anymore. If I don't pull enough, they start letting go and chewing and moving around on the toy. So that window is very narrow. As the dog gets older and stronger, physically stronger, that window gets a little wider. So one of the things that we talk about when we talk about playing with a dog is, if I'm playing tug with a little puppy, I have to be very cautious about how hard I pull and my tugging fundamentals. When we get dogs that are, and we're starting to actually use tugs, so let's say the dog's post-teething, 6-7 months old, that window's larger, but it's still important that I tug in a narrow window, basically hard enough to keep the dog engaged, but not so hard they're slipping off, and if I'm not soft enough to have the dog chew around or slip or lose interest in the toy.